Welcome back to the Curious Developer. We have talked about LLMs and how they operate when you are developing software. But one thing that is still bothering me quite a bit is, what is the legal situation for this? Am I going to be sued by my boss? Am I going to be sued by whoever on the internet is looking at my source code? There are so many questions. So fortunately, I have the luxury of talking to a lawyer, and I'm just taking my notes here so that I do pronounce her name correct. Dr. Lise Kade from KDAB. That's German. I'm really good at German, as you can tell. Welcome, Lisa. Did I pronounce your name correct?
Thank you. Yes, you did.
Okay, awesome. So, Lisa, I'm not even sure what kind of questions I ought to be asking you. So maybe we'll start there. What questions should I be asking a lawyer when it comes to AI and large language models and so on?
Well, there are some questions which I get asked a lot, and most of them go towards the direction of copyright, obviously, as you already indicated in your introduction. So one of the questions that should be talked about probably, but disclaimer already, there is no clear answer, is whether the code that is being created by using LLMs is actually copyright protected. So whether the code I produce when I'm using a large language model in my code base can actually protect it to my good or to the good of my company. The second question that it's really relevant in this context is whether I actually can just use a large language model in my company's code base, or whether there are legal aspects to consider, for example, data protection or copyright aspects, again, because the large language model might be roaming around in my own code base. And another question that might be interesting is whether LLMs actually use my code for improving their models and services.
Okay, it seems like I have an easy job here. I don't need to even come up with the questions to ask. So thanks for that. That's truly interesting. So let's get started with the first one. Is my code being copyrighted when I use LLMs?
Yeah, well, as I already indicated, it kind of depends. It depends, of course, on the jurisdiction, so which kind of copyright regime we are talking about. And it depends on how much you actually exercise control over your large language model. So whether you can direct the large language model into a direction that would produce code that can be attributed to your input, so that can be attributed to your effort, so to say. Whether it is a personal intellectual creation is usually the question that we ask when we are talking about copyright protection. So whether the output that you produce, whether being it by just typing some code in, or being it by typing, or being it by using a large language model, is actually the incorporation of, in the manifestation, if you wish, of your personal intellectual creation. And the issue with large language models is that, of course, we cannot always completely predict what they are outputting. So they are to some degree acting in a manner that would appear, as a lot of people call it, as a black box, or other people would call it acting more or less coincidentally. So we cannot in each and every instance predict what the output will be, and that is why a lot of people use this, or this is an argument that a lot of people use to explain that the output generated by AI is more or less random and cannot be attributed to a human's input. But LLMs are providing more and more control to a human. So for example, when you are using Copilot in a setting where you actually use a chat function, or you use a comment to describe whatever you want to implement, you are able in a lot of instances to explain what you wish to accomplish by using the LLM in a manner that the LLM does not really have that much leeway to actually decide how in which order to implement which function, but it rather translates your wishes into the syntax of the programming language that you want to use. So in that case, you would direct the LLM into a very concrete direction, and we might be able to attribute that to you as a human author. But that again, depends on the copyright regime we are talking about. In many instances, the output created by an AI system will not be copyright protected because it's more or less either too much of a random output or it's too little creative to be awarded copyright protection because it's just helping you in what would be otherwise rather unnerving typing work that you want to avoid by using the LLM. But it is also not an issue for you as a developer as long as you are still thinking of the entire concept of your program. So as long as there is a human person steering the entire idea of the program you are developing, and the LLM is just helping you, assisting you in providing you a shortcut for things that you would have to type that would be the same for any other developer who would be implementing the software, you would probably in most jurisdictions still be the author of the program as a whole, but some snippets might not be copyright protected individually.
So what you're basically saying is that if I have a switch statement in my code that goes over colors, blue, green, and yellow, then the concept of a switch statement will not be copyrighted, but the function which does something super complex and smart and that I invented will still as a whole be copyrighted.
Yeah.
That's reassuring to hear that I'm not throwing all my software out there copyrightless or whatever that's called. So let me just, I like to, when I ponder upon things, I like to try and take things to the very extreme, just to see where things break down and so on. So imagine, I don't know how much you know about Qt, but it's a dual license. So there's a GPL out there that is similar to the semicolon of the licensed version from the Qt company, but they are different licensed. If I manage to somehow tell an AI exactly what Qt looks like, down to the very that there should be a button that you can press, and you should be able to call set text on that button to set the text, and it took input from the open source GPL versions of Qt and produced exactly the same thing, would I then be the copyright owner of that? And so I like, last century we talked about greenwashing. I wonder if there's a new copyright washing through sending through things an LLM so that it would be giving me the copyright.
That's a great question. And actually, I think there's even more than just one question hidden in this aspect you just suggested. So there would be a question of whether you would be the author of the output generated by the LLM, which is basically what I just answered before. So it really depends on how much you steer it into the direction. Mm-hmm. Then there is a question of whether the output that is generated is so similar to what is being used in the training data that the output would be regarded as a copy of the training data. And the copying of the training data would be something that the author, so Qt in that case, would have to allow or would have to license in some way. And if you are creating a copy of something that is otherwise protected, you would have to adhere to the licensing conditions. And it doesn't really matter how you arrive at that concept, because it is clear that you knew the concept before, so you knew what the original was like. And it is not like an independent creation. It is a duplication. You just arrived at the duplication in a very complicated manner. So you did not just take it and copy it, but you used a way through a machine learning system that produced the same output. But if we compare the output and the input, and it's the same, so it is literally just copying the functions, the code that was there before, then we still have a copyright infringement if you are not adhering to the licensing conditions imposed by Qt. And then there's a third aspect, which you mentioned, is we could also go in a way to copy the idea and not the manifestation of the idea. And at least in most European copyright jurisdictions and also in the German copyright jurisdiction, the idea is not protected by copyright. It is the manifestation that is copyright protected. And if you manage to describe the idea of Qt to the LLM and the LLM comes up with a code solution that is not copied from the original code base, but that it finds a different way to implement this idea, that might be not infringing on the original copyright holder's rights, but it might also be not your copyright that is being created if you are not steering the LLM enough to be awarded copyright protection for the output.
Interesting. And of course, Qt is millions of lines of code, so I would be spending a few decades trying to explain exactly what I wanted to be able to replicate that. And just to be clear to the audience here, you are a lawyer in Germany, so what you're centering around is German law, but obviously these things are international, given that software are likely to be not just sold to a single market, but to possibly many markets.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay, that was question number one. The number two you said is, can I use LLMs on my company data or in my company, or what are my issues with that?
Yeah, that kind of depends on how the LLM system works. So whether the LLM system is using and actually reading your code base and then possibly copying your code base or using it for training there and further improving their LLM models. And if this is the case, then you would have to make sure that you own all the rights of the data that is being copied by the LLM system, because as I explained before, the creation of the copy would require a license or a permission by the author. And if there is code in your code base that is derived from a third party, you might not have the right to provide it to the LLM in this manner that it is being copied and stored on the LLM provider server, for example. If the LLM is running locally in your infrastructure, this might not be the issue at all. And if you have all of the rights of the code involved, this might just be an issue of you as a developer, that you as a developer would have to clarify with your employer whether it's fine for them as a copyright holder to be copying and sending all of the data to the LLM provider. And there's other aspects than copyright. In some cases, there might be personal data in the code. For example, it's probably not best practice, but you can imagine that there are names sometimes in a code base that would amount to personal identifiable information, which would then, of course, in turn also be processed by the LLM provider, and which would require some kind of at least reflection about the issue, whether this is fair dealing with the personal information or whether you would need permission. And then there's a third aspect, which is trade secrets or company secrets, which might also, of course, leak when you are training an LLM or training a third party LLM provided by an external LLM provider, which might then process your secret company secret information and include it in their training. And there might be ways of prompting that system later on, which would leak your trade secret, which is, of course, also not something that you would want to deal with your employer with.
So I can't help thinking the very first sentence you said for this answer is that if there's third party in there, I mean, it got to be a very trivial hello world if there's no third party software in my own software. I mean, if it's a GraphQL user interface, then I have all of Qt in there to start with.
Yeah. One point that I omitted before is that in some cases or in many cases, you have the option to choose an account type with the LLM provider that does promise you that they are not training their systems with the code they are reading and that they are not storing and further processing the code that they are reading, which would then help you in that aspect. But it is important to familiarize yourself with the options that are out there and with the fact that this information, be it copyrighted material, personal data, or trade secrets, might leak if you are just using a free version of an LLM.
So I guess the good old saying of if you're not their customer, you're their product also applies here, that if you're using the free version, you can be pretty sure that that they will be using your data to
train. I mean, yeah, it's you're paying with your data.
And I like how you managed to lawyer me into talking about GDPR right here. So we have the words of all
GDPR.
If there's personal data in there, yeah. So, but you are of course right. I mean, there could be easily be in the source code or somehow easily extracted from their personal data. That should be careful. And then you mentioned the last thing about trade secrets in the code. I guess again, if you use a general purpose LLM, then it might just by accident learn about your trade secret. Obviously, my competitor need to be asking very clever questions to get those out of it. But nevertheless, it's a risk. And I guess in legal term, where do I stand as a software developer? Do I need my boss to sign some paperwork that allows me to use LLMs, or is it enough that we just do that in the organization, or how do I stand?
Well, you would definitely have to have some kind of, or it would be recommended to have some kind of documentation that it is just not just your idea to sign up for the LLM and use it in your code. It should be a decision of your employer, and I think it should be documented in the same way that you would document any other business decision that is not up to you to make. You would probably, from my perspective, it would probably be enough to have an email, but this definitely depends on the jurisdiction and probably also on the ways that your company is usually dealing with these kinds of aspects.
Okay. Your final question that you suggested is, will LLM use my code to improve their models? And I guess we talked a bit about the best way, and we saw that in previous episode of The Curious Developer, is to have a own dedicated server running with my own models that I use for this. And second best would be at least to have a commercial license with my provider of the AI models. And then if I am on an open source, I might get away with just using the free versions out there. But commercial, I definitely need to think very careful.
Yeah, definitely. That's a recommendation that I would give also for other questions that might come up. Many questions that are arising in the legal context can be solved from my perspective with running your own LLM and just not relying on an external provider.
Okay, that brought a bit of clarity to my understanding of the world around this. Right after I stop talking, your contact information will be on the screen. And that is definitely a suggestion to hand on to seek legal help with these kind of questions, because at the end of the day, it would be devastating to your business if by all means, or by any chance, that somebody managed to sue you for stealing their property. Thank you very much for joining me here, Lisa.
Thank you very much for having me.